Hey everyone, we are 2 a.m. That's two assholes and a microphone. My name is Dirk. This is Crystal. Look who's feeling better. And today we have Dax, the child of God.
This was requested by Dripflix Media. He's asked multiple times, and we're glad to get it done. We actually have already recorded this once, and it messed up, so this is going to be a review, not a reaction.
Yeah.
Sorry about that.
We were all created in God's image.
I like that he's playing the part kind of the Samaritan, you know, helping with the cross.
Yeah, helping him carry his burden.
Although I believe it was the Good Samaritan that brought him water, but yeah.
Dear God, thank you for leading me down this path. I'm thankful for the man that I am. At first, I didn't understand. Now I see the tribulations that I faced were all part of the plan. I tried to walk away, I wasn't whole. You fill the gap inside my heart and let me know I had a soul. I was bleeding on the inside.
I like how he said, let me know I had a soul.
Yeah. Fill the gap. I like the way he's phrasing things here. And to my point of view, you don't even have to be a Christian to understand what he's saying there.
Yeah.
There are plenty of secular ways of saying the same thing. It's the hardships that you go through, the lessons you learn from that help build who you're meant to be.
Whole, you fill the gap inside my heart and let me know I had a soul. I was bleeding on the inside, nobody could see. Then I looked into the mirror, he was staring back at me.
That's
now
right.
I gotta say, I was...
Yeah, you look into the mirror, he was staring back at you because nobody else could see what you were going through.
Mm-hmm.
It's one of those things where it's like, you gotta see that spark inside yourself and grow it from there.
Nobody could see. Then I looked into the mirror, he was staring back at me. Now I gotta say, I was lost, where'd I go? Now I'm here, glory road, child of God, not a sheep. Lost my way, came on home, used to think the world was cold. And
I like that, child of God, not a sheep.
I've heard the people refer to people as flock members, and you know, the preachers and such are the shepherds and things like that, and it kind of makes it sound a little Stepford in my case, in my opinion.
Well, the way I see it, it's more like you don't have to just go along with what everybody is saying and necessarily even what your preacher or your pastor has to say. You need to find that connection with the higher power, however you see that higher power, whether it's the, whether it's God or the creator, the universal consciousness, the great spirit, however you see that power of creation, you have to connect with that within yourself.
I was fighting all alone until I made that call and heard his voice and touched right through that phone. All my pain, all my stress, had it to the dumb neglect. I used to take my burdens and disperse them around to all my friends. Anger and frustration was a...
Used to take my burdens and disperse them around all my friends.
Oh, how many people do that? I everybody's guilty of it, at least to some degree.
Yeah, a lot of that has to do with sharing the misery.
Yeah, I think that's part of it. The urge to have, to just get that out of you and place it somewhere else rather than dealing with where it's coming from within you.
The dumb neglect, I used to take my burdens and disperse them around to all my friends. Anger and frustration was a means, but never to an end until you picked me up and took that weight right up off my chest. A child of God, nothing more, nothing less. Born sinner, not by choice, but also born blessed. I could feel the pressure building up.
Born a sinner, not by choice, but also
born blessed.
Born blessed.
You know, or we all have that in us, both of those things. you have the temptations to do wrong, but you also have the blessings and the gifts that are natural to you that are meant for you to do something with.
Yeah.
Nothing less, born sinner, not by choice, but also born blessed. I could feel the pressure building up and choking at my neck. Then God told me take a breath and he would handle all the rest. I'm not a stranger to evil, I've done wrong to people. I've told lies, but in his eyes I am still equal. My words weaponized, bars save lives, they lethal and take off in the sky. Spread.
Words weaponized, yeah. Especially in his line of work.
Yeah.
Equal, my words weaponized, bars save lives, they lethal and take off in the sky, spread wings like eagles. My life's an open book, something for the world to see. People watching what I do, so I'm careful of words I speak. Came up as
people watching what I do, so I'm careful of words I speak. I think that's a lesson everybody should take to heart. Like, I believe that there's power in what you say, and just about every religion there is talks about, in some way, the power of the word.
And it doesn't matter if you're, you know, an entertainer, anybody, a celebrity of any sort. Your words are going to affect somebody, so you really should be a little more careful with the words that you use. And
make sure that it's authentic. Make sure that you mean what you're saying. And try to have some compassion with it. Although, that's hard.
Yeah.
I'm a fiery person. I have a temper. So, I get that that's very hard.
Book, something for the world to see. People watching what I do, so I'm careful of words I speak. Came up as a child, I never thought that this was what I'd be. But now that it's my path, I swear to God that I won't fail to lead. Speaking positivity with...
I like that. Now that's my path, I swear to God I won't fail to lead. That's awesome.
Yes, it is.
What I'd be, but now that it's my path, I swear to God that I won't fail to lead. Speaking positivity with every single breath I breathe. Working up to God, I'm on my hands and down on my knees. Asking him to grant me with the strength in this world of greed. To be the person that will have a shoulder when they need to lean. Promises I...
You promise to be the man who has a shoulder when they need to lean.
Mm-hmm.
That's a great thing to do, but you need to be careful that you don't go from being a shoulder to lean on to
being a crutch.
To being a crutch, yeah.
You also got to be careful who you share your burdens with and make sure it's somebody you can trust to hold those and help you through them and not to use those as weapons against you.
Yep.
Strength in this world of greed, to be the person that will have a shoulder when they need to lean. Promises I made to you, God, yes, I will keep. May not be who they want, but I'm making what they need. Rose from the dirt in the middle of the concrete and bloom to a tree to create and disperse seeds. Impact is what I breathe.
Go back just a minute.
Keep, may not be who they want, but I'm making what they need. Rose from the dirt in the middle of the concrete and bloom to a tree to create and just
rose from the dirt in the middle of the concrete and bloomed into a tree. That's awesome. I like that.
Yeah, coming from the nearly impossible beginnings,
right,
to stand tall and proud. I like that. Good imagery.
Mm-hmm.
Disperse seeds, impact is what I bleed. Won't fall for anything. I answer to God, I don't answer to no human being.
I answer to God, I don't answer to no human being. Yeah, that's something that people look to other men and rely on them so heavily sometimes that they forget that even the strongest, wisest of men
are just men.
They're fallible and they have issues. They're not perfect either. So you can't hold them at too high a standard because no one can live up to that besides the Creator.
Yep.
But I bleed, won't fall for anything. I answer to God, I don't answer to no human being. I am not a slave, I am not the devil, nor a fiend. I'm a child of God, just like you, we on the same team. Grab my hand, stand up, I won't leave you. You need me, just as much as I need you. Fight these battles with me, I promise that you will see through and stand tall over things beneath you. Child of God, he is I, and you are him. To see God, we must first look within. Nowhere else, no place, no human, no race, just us and faith till we meet again. It's Dax. We're all created in God's image.
I like that. That's beautiful. And again, with the cinematography,
it's
absolutely gorgeous. I feel like too many people are focusing on the wrong things.
Way too often, yeah.
And they forget that we all need each other to make this world go round.
Mm-hmm.
Period.
Yeah. A lot of people are really focused on what's going on in their life, what's going on, you know, what they need and what they need to do and things like that. And sometimes you just have to take a step back from all that. And once you are able to separate yourself from your immediate
problems,
you can look around and say, well, this person's having some issues. That's not all that difficult for me to handle, to help them with.
Right.
And once you start doing that, if more people started doing that, you could find this nice network of friends, and everything can be worked out in a much easier way. They say that a burden shared is a burden halved. So.
Right. I think, too, it's a matter of, as a whole, people need to take a step back and have some gratitude for the good things in their lives, regardless of how badly they're doing now. And we've been down real low, low before. And
nearly homeless.
He's been homeless before. And when you can still find the good and something to be grateful for and appreciative of in those times, it helps you keep going and keep reaching for better. And when you can help somebody else out who's doing maybe worse off than you, it actually helps you feel better as well. But in any case, thank you.
Very much so, yes. This is a great continuation of Dear God, I think.
Yeah, I like the way Dax does this because he does it in a very humble, humane way. He's not preachy. He's not saying how much more righteous he is than other people because of his beliefs.
No, he actually includes everybody in it.
Mm-hmm. I really appreciate this. Thank you. Like, share, subscribe, ring our little bell. You know, do all the little things.
Leave a comment down below for us.
Be blessed, y'all.
Peace.